For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Latin America's Ecuador is the latest victim of neoliberalism and its onslaught on the working classes. Fearing the massive mobilizations undertaken by Ecuadorian masses, its far-right government led by President Lenin Moreno has imposed emergency in the country. As part of the mobilizations, major highways and roads were blocked across the country on October 3rd from the early hours of the morning. Thousands gathered in major cities to protest Moreno's latest economic measures. In the afternoon, in response to the mass protests, Moreno declared a state of emergency, allowing the executive greater powers like ability to mobilize funds, censure media, deploy police and military, and shut transportation hubs. None of this has deterred the will of the working people in Ecuador. Even under heavy police repression with tear gas and baton attacks, they continued their mobilizations throughout the night. Around 277 protesters were detained. On Tuesday, October 1st, President Lenin Moreno had announced a new set of economic austerity measures based on agreements made with the International Monetary Fund, or IMF, in exchange for $4.2 million in aid. Moreno's neoliberal package includes the elimination of four decades-old subsidies on petroleum and diesel, tax changes and labor reforms. This takes away the hard-fought rights of workers, including cutting public sector workers' vacation time in half and establishing that temporary work contracts, when renewed, will have 20% less remuneration, among other things. In addition to these, the IMF recommended Moreno's administration bring down the number of public sector workers and increase private participation in state-owned companies. Trade unions, social and political organizations in Ecuador have vehemently denounced the measures as another attack on the most vulnerable sections of the country by a government set on sacrificing the well-being of the people in order to appease international institutions. Along with peasant organizations, fishing communities, neighborhood organizations and students, they call for mass mobilizations and blockades across the country on October 3rd.
Estamos aquí protestando por todas las medidas adoptadas por el gobierno. Ya decimos basta, somos madres, somos hijos, somos seres humanos que queremos vivir en un país mejor.
Transportation workers' unions declared that they were entering into permanent mobilization and that they were on an indefinite strike, as they stood to be the most affected by the elimination of fuel subsidy. This strike is the third time that Ecuador has experienced a complete shutdown since Moreno took office. The resentment towards his government and policies has only been on the rise. The recent defeat of the legalization of abortion in cases of rape, growing unemployment, and general economic insecurity have added to the public feeling frustrated and betrayed by the government. While Moreno ran for president on a promise to continue the legacy of Rafael Correa and the citizen revolution, he has shown time and again that his allegiance is to the imperial powers and international financial institutions instead. The neoliberal economic reforms and agreements with the IMF, the military agreement with the United States, cancelling of asylum for whistleblower Julian Assange, and support to the far-right Venezuelan opposition are clear indicators that Moreno has all but continued the legacy of Latin American integration and anti-imperialist stances that characterized the prior government. Protests are expected to continue in the coming days.